Erythema marginatum is a skin condition characterized by distinct red, raised, and expanding rings that often appear on the trunk and limbs. It is associated with several underlying health conditions and is often considered a manifestation of rheumatic fever. In this video, we will explore erythema marginatum overview, meaning, causes, sign and symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, home remedies, and frequently asked questions. By the way, welcome to our channel. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe. What is the meaning of erythema marginatum, word by word? Erythema refers to redness or inflammation of the skin, while marginatum is derived from the Latin word margo, which means margin or border. In the medical context, marginatum is used to describe a particular pattern or appearance of a skin rash that has clear borders or edges. Therefore, erythema marginatum refers to a skin condition where there is redness and inflammation of the skin, characterized by the presence of distinct, well-defined borders or edges on the rash. Causes of erythema marginatum. Causes of erythema marginatum include rheumatic fever, a condition triggered by untreated streptococcal infections, and certain strains of group A streptococcus bacteria. Other possible causes may exist, but these are the primary factors associated with the development of erythema marginatum. Signs and symptoms of erythema marginatum. The hallmark symptom of erythema marginatum is the appearance of pinkish-red rash patches with distinct borders. These patches are often painless and do not itch. Apart from the skin lesions, individuals with erythema marginatum may experience other associated symptoms, such as fever. Some individuals may develop a low-grade fever accompanying the rash. Joint pain. Joint pain and swelling, particularly in the larger joints like the knees, elbows, and ankles, can occur in conjunction with erythema marginatum. Fatigue. Feelings of tiredness and lack of energy are common. Cardiac symptoms. In cases where erythema marginatum is associated with rheumatic fever, individuals may exhibit symptoms like chest pain, shortness of breath, or palpitations due to inflammation of the heart. Diagnosis of erythema marginatum. Diagnosing erythema marginatum involves a combination of clinical examination and laboratory tests. Healthcare professionals will assess the characteristic appearance of the rash and inquire about the patient's medical history. Key diagnostic steps include clinical examination. During the clinical examination, the healthcare provider will carefully observe the rash's appearance, distribution, and any associated symptoms. The distinctive nature of erythema marginatum, with its well-defined borders and preference for certain body areas, aids in its identification. Laboratory tests. To confirm the diagnosis and determine the underlying cause, various laboratory tests may be conducted. These tests may include throat swabs, blood tests to check for the presence of antibodies indicative of streptococcal infections or rheumatic fever, and echocardiography to evaluate heart function. Treatment of erythema marginatum. Treating erythema marginatum involves addressing the underlying cause and managing the symptoms. The treatment approach typically includes management of underlying conditions. For individuals with erythema marginatum associated with rheumatic fever, treating the underlying streptococcal infection is crucial. This may involve a course of antibiotics to eradicate the bacteria and prevent further complications. Medications. In some cases, healthcare professionals may prescribe medications to manage the symptoms and reduce inflammation. Nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, can help alleviate joint pain and reduce fever. For more severe cases, corticosteroids may be prescribed to suppress inflammation. Lifestyle changes. Adopting a healthy lifestyle is important for overall well-being and managing the symptoms of erythema marginatum. This includes maintaining good personal hygiene, getting adequate rest, and following a balanced diet to support the immune system. Home remedies for erythema marginatum. In addition to medical treatments, there are several home remedies that can help alleviate discomfort and promote skin healing. These remedies include soothing skin care. J. Gentle skin care practices, such as using mild, fragrance-free cleansers and moisturizers, can help soothe the skin and prevent further irritation. Avoiding harsh chemicals and excessive sun exposure is also recommended. Natural remedies. Some natural remedies may offer relief from the symptoms of erythema marginatum. Aloe vera gel, chamomile tea compresses, and oatmeal baths are known for their soothing properties and can help reduce redness and inflammation. Dietary considerations. Eating a balanced diet rich in fruits, vegetables, and whole grains can support the immune system and aid in the healing process. Avoiding foods that may trigger inflammation, such as processed foods and sugary snacks, is advisable. Frequently asked questions about erythema marginatum. Can erythema marginatum occur without rheumatic fever? Yes. Erythema marginatum can occur without rheumatic fever, although it is less common. It is important to identify the underlying cause and seek appropriate medical attention. Are there any long-term complications associated with erythema marginatum? If left untreated, rheumatic fever, which can be associated with erythema marginatum, may lead to serious complications affecting the heart, joints, and other organs. Prompt diagnosis and proper treatment can help prevent these complications. Can erythema marginatum be cured completely? Erythema marginatum itself is a symptom of an underlying condition. While the rash can be treated and managed, the underlying cause, such as rheumatic fever or streptococcal infections, requires appropriate medical management. Are there any specific precautions to prevent erythema marginatum? Maintaining good personal hygiene, promptly treating streptococcal infections, and following a healthy lifestyle can help reduce the risk of developing erythema marginatum. Regular medical checkups are also important for early detection and management of any potential underlying conditions. Can over-the-counter creams or ointments cure erythema marginatum? Over-the-counter creams or ointments may provide temporary relief for symptoms like itching or dryness, but they cannot cure erythema marginatum. It is essential to consult a healthcare professional for a proper diagnosis and appropriate treatment plan. Are erythema multiforme, erythema nodosum, erythema infectiosum, erythema toxicum, and erythema marginatum similar conditions? Are there any differences between them? Erythema multiforme, erythema nodosum, erythema infectiosum, erythema toxicum, and erythema marginatum are all skin conditions that involve redness of the skin due to inflammation. The reason why they all have erythema in their names is that erythema is a medical term that refers to redness of the skin caused by inflammation. While these skin conditions share the feature of redness and inflammation, they have different causes and pathophysiologies. For example, erythema nodosum is a type of panniculitis that results from a delayed hypersensitivity reaction to various triggers, such as infections, medications, and autoimmune diseases. In contrast, erythema multiforme is a hypersensitivity reaction to certain medications or infections, such as herpes simplex virus or mycoplasma. Erythema marginatum is a skin rash that is associated with rheumatic fever, while erythema infectiosum is a viral infection caused by parvovirus B19. Erythema toxicum, on the other hand, is a common rash in newborns that is benign and self-limited. Therefore, these conditions have different pathophysiologies and causes, and should be diagnosed and treated properly by a healthcare provider. Thanks for watching. Take care and stay safe.